Alright. Just make sure the game is being captured. I think I might have forgot to set it to gaming, but I can worry about that later. Sorry I was sick for the whole week. I think I got sick first on Friday last week. And I wasn't able to play Okie Dokie Literature Club then, because that's what I was planning on doing. I took Saturday and Sunday off. And then I immediately got sick again on Monday, and then I just got discharged from the hospital, so I'm sorry about that. We'll try and finish up Quesh? Yeah. Just trying to figure out where I gotta go. But I figured I'd play maybe for about an hour and a half tonight, maybe 2 hours like we normally do. Most likely not three, just because I'm kind of tired. It's been a long week for me. Although most of that week has been sleeping, so. I'm trying to figure out where to go. I guess we'll do Convoy first. That seems to be the one that is closest to us. I hope everyone's week is doing better than... everyone has a better week than I have. I'm going to try and stream tomorrow. And also on Saturday and Sunday as well. Just to make up for lost time as well. Because I feel bad that... I always feel bad when I'm not able to stream. When I'm supposed to, you know? Anyways, let's see what's in here. It's a story area. Okay, our story... I don't know which one of these is the, smuggler story one. But luckily, we can just stealth past everyone. But yeah, the one good thing about going to the hospital, though, is they have really good turkey sandwiches. The hospital food isn't actually that bad. I think the problem is when you go to the hospital, you're not really in a... Well, at least with me, like, I'm always feeling nauseous. I have a rumbly-tumbly, so I don't really want to eat most of the time. But the food actually there is pretty good at the hospital that I go to. Alright. I just gotta figure out what I'm supposed to activate. Locate the sensor station's processors.
Station is working as planned, Grand Admiral. Not a single ship has gotten past us since the sensors went fully operational.
Not a single ship.
This must be the smuggler storyline one.
Things right under your nose that you're blind to.
Sir, I assure you everything is under control. I have my best men guarding...
Had? What are you doing here? I thought you were on the leash of that shrew senator.
Who are you?
The Void Wolf, I presume?
Don't presume. And don't imagine that discovering the stolen fortune of some wheezing old gangster... with his own daughter's aid, prepares you to take me on.
Wrong number.
No. All right, let's take this guy out. Yeah, remember how to play. It's been a while.
Thank you.
Okay. Blow up one more of these things. Bada boom, bada bing. All right. So we gotta return to Captain Ozick, I think. But I know the story missions for Quest, there's only like two, right? It isn't very long, because, like, Quest is, like, an extra planet, sort of. Although we can go to Captain Ozick. But then, like, he'll just tell us to go to our ship, I guess. But I want to complete the, story missions for here. For this planet. For whatever reason, my autism always makes me want to complete the Quest, story arc. I don't know why. It's just the way it is. All right. I think I'm just gonna focus on, the zone story arc for now. It's cartel crushing. Okay. I don't know why the combat music is still going on. Let us go stealth again. Okay, looks like the entrance is over here. Technically, there's a Three Families war camp that we gotta go to. We haven't discovered yet. I'm assuming there's probably gonna be something over there as well. Okay. Okay, we gotta kill the droids. Alright. Oh, it says we do. Destroy cartel command droids. It says command droids. Okay, it's these ones. Oh, I think I done fucked up the rotation. Okay. Let's try and find another command droid. I see a bunch of Reaver droids. Okay, I guess the other command droids must be down here then. Yeah, I'm getting close to my goal, though, of getting to 50 subs, though, which is nice, before April 31st. I think I might actually make it. I wasn't sure if I was, but we're getting pretty close, which is nice, I guess. I'm hoping we can get there, because, I know one of my friends were telling me that once you get to, like, 100 subs, that's when your, channel tends to start getting, picking up. So, I'm really looking forward to it. It's been a lot of hard work this entire year trying to make sure I get, something out at least, once a day. Oh yeah, I forgot we can actually scavenge these guys. Alright, we just need two more of the command droids. And then evacuate factory workers, okay. Alright, we just need to find one more. Is this like the bonus or something? Okay, that is a bonus. Alright, so I want to collect these for the hut dude, I remember. As I remember, he was trying to get me to get these for a little bit of extra money, extra credits. So I do want to get that. Because why not? I mean, we're a smuggler, right? Okay. Boom. Okay. Alright, that's all the, droids. We got the, factory workers freed. Now we just need to get the drugs. Let me get that cocaine. So the hut can, like, sniff it off our butt or something. Crate over there. Experts med pack. I guess that can come in handy. All right, I'm just looking for, all right, we got 4 out of 8. Okay. All right, there's another one here. He's dead. And I really want to see if my, because my uncle, he works in like Hollywood and stuff. And he did a, and he was telling me you can, because I have like the original Star Wars trilogy on video cassette. And I really want to like get them into like a digital form so I can watch them. Just on my computer, make it a lot more easier, because I'm always paranoid of putting them in the VCR. because I'm worried that it's going to eat my tapes or whatever and just, like, have the film go everywhere, and then they'll be ruined, right? And, I want to be able to, because I like, the reason why I like the video cassette version of the original trilogy is because, a lot of the original trilogy, if you buy it now, it edits stuff, like, it makes it to where Han doesn't shoot Greedo first, and also it changes Boba Fett's voice. I like how Boba Fett's voice sounded in the original thing a lot more, because I just think it sounds a lot cooler than a Space Australian, you know? So, I'm hoping maybe I can get a hold of him and see if I can, like, give him to him, and then he can maybe try and get it into a digital version for me. Six out of eight. I seem to remember there being a few upstairs as well. What if I do this? There we go. Oh. I gotta go the other way. Not the way out. Oh, there's the last one. Harvest that. I will grab this crate of drugs. And that should alter the ending of the quest line for me. Can I just, like, teleport here? I can. Yeah, I'm just gonna do that. I'll be way faster. Yeah, I had, like, 3 IVs in me and stuff. And it's just really hard to go to sleep at the hospital, too, because it was freezing. Not only that, I was kind of too tall for the blankets, I felt. All right. Who do I talk to here? Major Treague.
Nice work in the factory. My men are routing the rest of the droid army as we speak.
Yeah, here you go.
I've got everything you asked me to look for, Broga.
Good of you to join us, General.
We are ready to strike the heart of the Imperial Army and regain control of this war. Our target is Imperial Moth Grayson, commander of Imperial Operations on Quesh.
One Moth, no problem.
Let me handle that for you.
We remain ever in your debt.
Moth Grayson is holed up in a heavily fortified palace. Your strike team must get inside, get to Grayson, and bring him back, preferably alive.
All right, sounds like a piece of cake.
I'll do it blindfolded, just for fun.
Our scouts only found one route in.
To Micha Kulka, to Maji, Taus Azalas Uval. Putula Musta, Wobranic Dampio, to Pushiwompa.
All right. Once I'm inside, what then?
If you know anything else about this area, now's the time.
I doubt my commandos can make it through the front doors alive, but they will go down trying.
We'll do the good option.
I have a better chance at making it through the doors than your men.
That's very noble of you. Thank you. If all goes well, rendezvous with the second strike team once you're in. I'll be here with enough men to defend Broga, in case the Empire decides to retaliate.
I will meet you here when the mission is complete. Good luck.
The entire Republic is hoping for
your success.
I'm gonna try and, make a snack after this. Alright, so where's the map want me to go? It looks like we can get there if I go right. Go, what is it, east? East we shall go then. We're almost, I think we're a little... I think after this planet we'll be, I'm pretty sure, halfway done with, No, we did Balmora, that's right, and then it's this one, and then it's Hoth. So we're almost done with Chapter 2, I think. And then we just gotta do Chapter 3, which is, it's the prison planet, Voss, and then Corellia. Yeah, we're almost done with the smuggler storyline, then. Then we can move on to one of the Empire characters again. I'll put on a vote, but, I think last time, I think only two people voted, though. But, if that's the case, I'll just, pick what I want to play, then, if, nobody votes, which is no problem, because I don't really have that many people watching all the time, so it's no big deal. And if there's a tie, I'll just break the tiebreaker then. Okay. Speak to the Red Squad Captain. Okay. There we go. Okay.
I can't believe you survived that gauntlet. Are you made of Durasteel? Bound to be trouble up ahead.
There's always trouble ahead.
Story of my life. Always someone lurking, waiting to kill you. You get used to it?
You heard the order, men. Move out.
Oh, nice. We're level 42. Locate Moff Drayson. I wonder if this is the last one.
I would offer you some of these excellent adrenals, but my warriors have used the last of them.
I don't need any.
There's no shortage of adrenals.
I don't do drugs, I sell them.
I'm practically throwing them away now.
I hope you realize what an honor you have been given today. You will play a pivotal role in galactic history. Your deaths will be the final outrage that forces the Republic's hand. And now I think it is time to conclude this.
Kidoki. Alright, he's down. And they said they wanted him alive, so we'll do that. That's what the job parameters are.
Do you think you've won? The Republic's hold on Quesh is at an end. I wouldn't expect a common thug to understand. So I'll use small words. You have wasted your time. You never had the strength or the courage to strike the Empire down. And you never will.
All right.
Captain, restrain this man and escort him to the Republic base.
Gladly. You should go on ahead. General Corvan will meet you at the war camp to hear your report in person.
All right. There might be a third area or another area. I hope not. I just want to get off Quest and go move on to Hoth or whatever it is. Go to Snow Planet. I think me and my friends were watching the old Star Wars Robot Chicken. It was before I got sick, but we had fun watching that. That was a lot of fun. I forgot I owned them. I love the scene with the crate dragon trying to... It was like, oh, why would they make a planet based on one biome or whatever? I was like, oh, okay. Mysterious Sith Acolyte. Guy has a lot of health. Or maybe my followers focusing the other guy. At least I'm getting healed. There we go. Ooh, a belt of some kind.
Chonki Pakota, Jihopoda, Jioto Vokise.
My word. I expected trouble when I lost contact with Broga and Major Trigg, but I never imagined this.
Ono Nachatu, Nitutu Broga.
Greetings, General.
Lord Magras, I suppose it was only a matter of time before the Sith became involved in this war.
And what have we here? A grubby little space rat? Corvan.
Space rat, space rat.
Is this really the best you could find, Corvan? One of my deepest condolences.
You're just dumb.
I look sad? Try again, buddy.
It is with great sorrow that I must inform you of the defection of your valued servant and war hero, Major Trigg. You are standing in the midst of his handiwork. He killed his own soldiers to deliver Broga to me.
Chawa aite ya chachopa.
The hut is with me, in your former venom mine. Another gift from Major Trigg.
Well, why are you telling us this?
I'm sure you aren't giving us this information for our benefit.
I am issuing an invitation. Would you like these things back? Come to the mine and take them. My door is always open.
This is my fault. I should have seen it coming.
Alright. What can we do?
We need a plan to strike back.
As it stands, Quesh is lost. There's little time to regain control before Republic Command orders us off the planet. We must stop Lord Magris. And if the Major has turned against us, bring him to justice.
All right, I can handle this.
I won't blow this. Trust me.
All our hopes rest on you now. Find Lord Magris and Major Trigg. Put a stop to this. Save Broga if you can. I'll return to base to await your report. Good luck.
All righty. Oh man, I call a space rat. I was just thinking of the Aladdin song where they're calling Aladdin like a street rat, and it's like, gotta eat to live and or whatever. And gotta steal to eat or something. Oh man. I don't know why I would watch the live action like Aladdin when you have the cartoon one that's just fine with Robin Williams. I've been playing Baldur's Gate 3 again on my off time, and I modded the game to basically have the genie warlock and have Robin Williams essentially be my patron, which is nice. The genie warlock's pretty overpowered in that game too. I can understand why they don't have it in the game normally. It's a pretty strong class, or archetype for warlocks at least. Oh man. But like, I don't even, like, if you're playing like a high level campaign for D&D, I don't even know why you'd go Sorlock, because like there's a magic item that's pretty good. I think it's like the Illusionist Bracers. And they end up like making it to where you cast a cantrip, you can cast another cantrip as a bonus action, which just does the same thing as the Sorlock does. I think I went the wrong way. Yeah, I went the wrong way. Okay. But I would just invest in that. If granted, I knew I could get those items. Although most DMs, they, depending on what level you start at, they'll either let you get two uncommon magic items, or at least the ones I've played with, they'll let you have two uncommon magic items, or a rare item, and technically the Minor Illusionist Bracers are a very rare item. They're pretty sought after by warlocks, and in fact I think they're probably one of the best magic items a warlock can get, just because it lets them cast Eldritch Blast more. So, and really the only thing you'd want to ever multi-class if you had those bracers would be like fighter or something, really, because then you can also action surge and just blast even more. A bonus. I didn't know that. I mean, the bonus for the, there's like a couple bonuses actually. Okay. Well, I only have to kill like 8 of them. Take the neutralizers? Okay.
I'm sure I'll find a use.
Okay, so now I can. There's poisoned workers. Okay. I think tomorrow, I'm not sure if I'll play this, because I do have to go to the show up for the TTRPG, or the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle thing that I added a playlist to. That you can check out. It's not on my channel, though, so it's on another person's channel. But I'm hoping to have fun with that again. And it's pretty nice because I don't really know the system that well. And we're playing a bunch of pre-made characters, I guess. But it's still pretty fun. Because I can roleplay the character however I want, right? But he's also kind of building the sheet for us too, so. Because I guess it's a pretty complicated system or something. I just noticed that there's a stage for all of these guys. Okay, there's another worker here. We'll kill these ones because they're in the way. Well, it says just to kill strong ones. Okay. Now, maybe this one is doable. I was, like, thinking, it's like, oh, go kill 20 more or something. If it was that, I wouldn't bother doing it. I honestly still don't want to do it, but... rather just, help these guys. Okay, there's no one up there. I'm going to have my helmet on. There we go. I'm really looking forward to... because, like, all the, other Imperial classes are a lot of fun, too. I'm really looking forward to seeing what people want me to play. Hopefully, you know, they vote. I think the one I like the least coming up, I don't even know. Because I still like the Agent, but, I honestly like all the Empire classes. And, I don't really think any of the stories are bad, it's just obviously some are better than others. The reason I really wanted to play Smuggler is because Smuggler is probably my favorite storyline. Just because it's the first story I ever did on this game. But I'm excited to see what people want me to try out. Okay. So 10,000 XP. I think my thing's beeping. I'll have to take a little bit of insulin or see if it's low or something. I had some hash browns before I started, so it might be a little bit high. We'll take care of it. In a bit. I'll actually check after I'm getting done killing this guy. Or after I'm done, here. On the planet, that is.
You have a reprieve for the moment, Hut? We have visitors. Major, come and greet our guests.
You can't win!
You won't last 2 seconds against me.
Oh, bravado. How fascinating. No wonder Trigg grew weary of the Republic.
Republic is sick. Indecisive half-wits like Corvin make general while men of action get passed by. Despite all my talent and years of service, I'd have died a major in the Republic. The Empire will give me a fleet.
Yeah, you murdered your own... Yeah, Imperials don't like aliens.
The Empire isn't exactly a shining example of equality. They'll never give real power to a Zabrak.
It's true. You were exceedingly foolish to believe anything I promised you.
What?
That raw quesh venom will make you quite powerful before it kills you. Destroy our guest there, and I'll give you the antidote. Let's finish this.
Oh, I like his lightsaber color. He enjoys the purple lightsaber, same as me. Oh, wow. I'm, getting toasted. Orbital strike? Okay. There we go. That was close. Okay, he's dead. I mean, he's a traitor, so I'm just gonna let him die. I don't care if it is a light side option to spare him. He's a damn butt fucking traitor.
I shouldn't have trusted them. Please, forgive me.
No, I don't care if it's dark side. Go to the deepest, darkest circle of hell, my friend. All right, no problemo.
Not a problem.
Yeah, let's talk business later. One businessman to another. Alright, where does he want me to go? Oh, all the way back there. I'm actually gonna teleport here. Go turn in the one for my smuggler storyline. And then we'll turn in the other one, and then we'll get off the planet. I'm trying to think what I want to play tomorrow. If I want to play this, or play, continue playing Doki Doki Literature Club. But, I'll probably play Doki Doki on, Saturday, just because I don't have as much time then, and because I'm only playing the game, at least for, I'm gonna try and play it for an hour. It really depends on how fast I read it, though, right? Because, I know just it seems like every day in the game takes about an hour. But, we'll see, how far I can go. And I know on the, 28th, I think 28th is on a Wednesday, the, what is it? There's an event in Final Fantasy 14 where you can get, like, this car or something as a mount. And I would like to try and get that. That'd be fun. But I don't know what I need to do for it. I seem to recall it, you need a lot of, MGP from the, gold saucer to get the car or something. I don't know how much, though. I should have enough, but I'm not sure, though. But after, I'm gonna try and farm some, when I'm done here. And then, just focus on that instead of doing the duty roulettes. Because I really want to get that car. I've been wanting that car for a long time.
My first ship out undetected. Looks like you really took their system down.
I learned on Terrace. Always assume she can do anything she promises.
I guess I owe you then, Captain. What can we do for you once we've delivered these medicines to Skestel, that is?
You work for me now.
Report to Domus Polaran at Port Nowhere. He'll give you my first assignment.
But what about the refugees?
We're doing important work here. Without the medicine we bring, thousands of Republic freedom fighters could... never mind. I can see it's futile to appeal to your better nature. I won't go back on my word. My fleet will serve you long enough to pay off this debt. Then pray it's not too late to still affect this war. Good day, Captain.
All right.
I don't mind working for you, Captain, but I'll jump ship the minute you ask me to go against what I believe in.
Oh, no, no worries. Alright. Can I teleport again? Oh, we can almost teleport. We'll just wait for it to... for the cooldown to go away. If I do that, it should tell me. Alright. It's the Republic base.
Received word from Broga. You kept our operation safe and eliminated the Empire's masterminds. Major Trigg's death, unfortunate as it may be, brings justice to all the good men he betrayed. The Republic Army owes you a debt of gratitude.
All right. It was a pleasure to serve.
It's been an honor to serve with you, General.
I assure you, the honor has been all mine. It will take time to find and stamp out the remaining Imperial forces. As long as we remain here, you will be honored and welcomed.
What does this look like? It looks a bit goofy. Alright, well now we can get off this planet. We can travel to Hoth. I think we'll do the cutscene on Hoth, and then, we won't land on Hoth, or maybe we will, but, we'll probably end it there. I know today's stream is a bit short, and it's only because I'm extremely exhausted.
Master, you'll be pleased to know I added extra padding to all the...
Alright, let's, talk to everybody.
I envy you, Captain. You'll always be free to do as you please. That all changes for me, once I'm a queen.
Maybe you'll be in charge, though.
I thought the whole point of ruling a planet was to do whatever you feel like.
My ancestors tried that. It didn't work out. I've studied records about the Draen dynasty. They started from humble beginnings, distinguished themselves as war heroes, officially anyway. In reality, they backstabbed their way to power just like every other ruler. Some were better at it than others.
What about your father?
Why didn't Nock make his own play for the throne? He was king of the backstab.
He knew recovering the crown was essential to establishing legitimate rule. It's not enough to conquer a world. You have to hold it, too. Father had his failings, but he inspired loyalty. Whenever he defeated a rival gangster, he always freed the enemy slaves. He gave them a choice. Join him or take their chances elsewhere. No recriminations for anyone who left. The rest became family.
How many joined him?
Interesting way to recruit new talent. How many slaves actually signed on?
Those people had a lot of anger issues. Most were excited to have a job that let them express it. There was this one little Twi'lek girl who joined us. Best thief I ever met.
Oh, you won't be happy to be talking about Ved, are you?
We were like sisters. But when Father's organization collapsed, we got separated. I never found out what happened to her.
Yeah, you should look her up. I'm sure she's like, the top breeding slave of some Sith warrior somewhere or something.
Never too late to find her. If she's as good a thief as you say, she might come in handy.
That was a long time ago. Sometimes it's better to leave the past alone. You're really bringing out my chatty side today. That usually means I need to get some exercise. Let's find something more exciting to do than stand around.
Okay, ooh, she has more to say.
I'm reviewing the holovids of Debrillion. Beautiful planet. Amazing oceans and forests. One of these days I'll have to see it in person.
You've never been there.
How can you be sure the planet's even worth ruling? For all you know, it smells like a wet bantha.
I hire Bothan spies to pose as tourists.
I didn't know that was what my character was gonna say.
Even the smells. Father warned me to stay away from that planet before he went into hibernation. The spaceport has genetic scanners keyed to the Draen bloodline. The king's doing everything in his power to keep me away. I'm not taking over without inside help. Until then, I have the holovids.
Alright. Part of the problem with BioWare games is sometimes you don't know what your character is going to say. Oh, Jesus.
You are not what I expected, Captain. I've seen you in battle. I know you can fight. But I've been killing Jedi and Republic troopers since my childhood, and you are nothing like them.
How am I not like them?
You mean a coward with no discipline and no greater loyalty than myself?
My father would have thought so. He would have seen no honor in fighting a woman who uses words and tricks to turn a battle. But I have seen your victories. I believe you are a worthy foe.
Is that a good thing?
Was I just complimented or insulted?
It was meant as praise. A warrior can only challenge yourself against enemies of honor and courage. There is no honor in attacking those beneath you. A worthy foe is a gift. In defeating them, we hone ourselves to the best we can be and bring honor to the name Mandalorian. Or so I was taught.
All right. Who else can we talk to? We can talk to Bodar.
Bodar. Yeah. I do not stop thinking of the gambler, the one who abandoned me to Druga. It was my own fault. I chose to go with him.
You chose him?
Why's that?
My owner then was an Imperial slaver. He used me for hard labor all day, then the pits at night. The gambler promised to treat me with honor, only the best fights. I convinced my owner I was too dangerous to keep.
I bet that was easy.
Wouldn't take much convincing.
The Imperial was a coward. The gambler paid little for me. I sat in his hold for months, then he dumped me with Druga to cover a gambling debt. Better to stay an Imperial slave. Never enjoyed killing in the arena except...
Oh, okay, well, I'm not reading it this time. He's going too fast. He's too fast for me. The ambitious on our list, they hunt like animals to wear our skins. Well, not while I'm around.
Any Trandoshan who comes after your people gets the business end of my blaster.
Definitely. No question about it.
You saved more than me when you took me from Druga. Well, yeah, because you would have killed them. I mean, didn't he, like, kill a Jedi or something? Oh, that's right. We haven't done, what was it? There was, wasn't there a quest for, no, it was this one, in a pickle, there we go. Let's do that one. So we gotta travel to Tatooine. Let me, make sure I'm not, tracking any others. And then we can do this one quest for, what's his face, or whatever. Ugh. And then we can travel to Hoth. In this question, it'd take too long, I would imagine. We just gotta find some dude and talk to him. And, make sure he's okay. I forget what town you... I wonder if you start out in Mos Eisley on the Republic side. Is Anchorhead? No, okay, then this isn't Mos Eisley. I wonder if Mos Eisley is even around in the Old Republic era. And I really wish I was big and strong. That way I could open up pickle jars. Speaking of the quest name. And that's how you know I'm sort of a woman. Because I can't open up pickle jars. The true test of manhood is if you can open up a pickle jar by yourself. But I guess on the bright side for me, every female is a muscle mommy to me. Because even a lot of females are stronger than me. With me having spaghetti noodle arms. So, I shouldn't be really talking too much shit.
Have a safe and pleasant stay.
But comes with the territory of being 6 feet tall and usually weighing anywhere. At the lowest weight I normally weigh is about 114 pounds. Most of the time I weigh 118, and when I'm doing good, I usually weigh about 124 pounds. But I'm hoping I can fix that. I'm trying to get a hold of some 20-pound weights, and then I'm going to lift those and drink protein powder stuff, so that should all be well and good. Okay, wow, this, where I need to go is pretty far away. Hopefully I can find the right way how to get there. I mean, it looks like I go down here, and then where my mouse is kinda goes south. there. Is what I'm assuming. Oh, bushwhack, what's that? Well, I'll put that at Control V. Because I don't think Control G works right. That's the one that opens up the flashpoints. For some odd reason. Oh, I think I went the wrong way. Well, maybe not. Let's see what this way, where this leads. Oh, no, that just leads to a heroic area. Okay. Well, we don't want to go that way then. Oh, wait, I see where I can go. I can go this way, maybe. Because it looks like it'll lead that way as well. I sometimes hate Tatooine. There's like so many windy turns on this planet. I kind of just want to get this quest done. That way I'm not missing out anything with the character. And stuff. This Corso. I'm gonna pretend I didn't forget his name. What's our alignment at? Okay. We're still technically a light side character. But as you can see, all these cliffs and stuff, I mean, this is why, at least for the most part, I still like Tatooine. I like Tatooine more than Alderaan, just because the quests are more interesting, but the terrain is a bit difficult to navigate. Yeah, tomorrow's Friday. I should have more time to do stuff on Friday. I think I just gotta be in that one Discord at around 5 o'clock my time, Pacific. 5 in the afternoon or at night or whatever. I think 5 o'clock is still technically afternoon, maybe. But and then on Saturday I'll play Doki Doki Literature Club and just play that for about however long one of the days in the game takes, just because I don't even know, maybe I'll play it for longer. It really just depends on how much of an attention span I have to read. Because maybe it's not the most optimal thing to only play it the game for an hour. Because it'll take forever to complete, right? So maybe I'll do more. But yeah. And I don't know how long the game is either. But I'm not gonna go for any secret ending shenanigans for that game. It's just, However the game ends, that's gonna be how it ends for me, I guess, because I can't, I'm not that interested in Doki Doki Literature Club to go for every possible secret or whatever. I was looking up into it, but yeah. And it's still kind of blind, because I've never seen anybody, like, play it. The only part I've seen is the one character that's, like, your childhood friend committing suicide. But that's all I've seen. But that was, like, a long time ago, and I forgot who I was watching do it as well, so. Let's do that so we dodge stuff. Oh, wow, am I, technically in a... Ooh. That almost ended poorly. I think I walked into an Imperial town. But I think I figured out why Monica might not be romanceable. It might, so it kind of spoiled a little bit for me, but, oh, well, I'm hoping she still is. I'm still thinking it's a dating sim. It might not even be a dating sim game. Or at least I know I was talking to my friends, they're like, wait, he still thinks it's a dating sim, so maybe it's not a dating sim. But I need to find, like, another dating sim game for next year for Valentine's Day. Depending on how much I like it, I might not finish it, though. Like, I'm gonna try and do for Doki Doki. Alright, let's go stealth. Them buying. Okay. Let me,
farewell.
Summon Corso.
Let's have us some fun, Captain.
Do you have a minute? We're looking for a stranger in your village.
A Twi'lek kid called Jettison. I got a call from him, place from here.
No strangers here. They don't like them. If you're smart, don't be one.
What's wrong? What's going on behind that shield?
Busy. Busy time. It's feast day, you know. Taste just like Banta.
What are you scared of? Does it have something to do with where everyone is?
Where everyone is? What everyone is? I'm a stranger here, too. They kidnapped me to be their doctor. They collar me at nights. There's something wrong with this place.
We're just here for Jettison.
I don't care about this pit stop. Just tell me about the kid.
It's too late for him. Get out while you can. The people here are crazy. And I treated them, dozens of them, for the laughing sickness. There's only one way to get that. Eating human flesh.
Well, I'm not a human, so... Looks like we're dealing with a bunch of cannibals.
There's two more fires. These strangers will be fresh meat tonight.
Die, cannibal.
You're never gonna hurt anyone again.
Kill them. Save the organs.
Three out of nine. Okay. Oh, there's still some up here. Let's get rid of them. There we go. I can go talk to Jettison and get him off this planet.
Corso? Is that you? How did you... I didn't think I would ever... Well, I heard they took in strangers who were new to the planet. And they locked me up and... Were they gonna eat me?
Yeah, you're safe now.
They're gone. I won't be hurting anyone again.
How did you end up here, Jed? I thought Serena got the whole crew.
I had the set cameras wired to my comm. I saw it all go down. Started running and I didn't stop until I hit Tatooine. I was trying to start over. After what Serena did, I've been too scared to go in anyone's systems. It was kind of a game for me, working for Vidu. It never really hit home to me that we were committing crimes. That people could die.
What are you gonna do now?
Well... Your peaceful village plan's a bust. What's next?
I don't know. I got nowhere to turn. Corso, is there anything...
Don't worry, Jed. We'll take care of you. Won't we, Captain?
You're the boss on this one. This is your friend.
If you want to do right by the kid, who am I to argue?
Go to Anchorhead. Should be some people there who owe me and the Captain a good turn. I'll try to set you up with some legit work. I think you've had enough of the wild side.
I'll say. Thank you, Corso. I can't think of anyone from the old crew I'd rather have find me. There's no one more loyal than Corso, Captain. You're lucky to have him.
Okay. Well, let's go back to our spaceship. Looks like Corso has a dialogue for us now as well.
You think about it at all? That craziness back on Tatooine? What makes a person desperate enough to start seeing his fellow men as meat?
They were nut jobs.
People go crazy. End of story.
I guess. But what a story, huh? You think anyone will believe it? Anyway, I heard from Jettison. He's recovering. He went back to Ord. He's looking for a job handling HoloNet security for the governor. Glad to know he's okay, you know? One thing to point at and say, we did some good here.
Fighting cannibals is good.
Yeah, those are people you could feel downright cheerful about killing.
When I was growing up, you know, good was good and bad was bad. Now, it's all these shades of gray, and even those aren't always true.
Okay.
You ever think about getting away from all this, Captain? The war, the huts, all of it? Ord's at peace now. It'd be a simpler life.
You want to give it up?
Aren't you the one who said we can't turn our backs on the war?
Nah, I was some other kid you picked up on Ord Mantell. After everything we've done... Guess I'm just feeling like hiding my head in the sand. Vidu always had something to say about that. Gets you shot in the end. Better to face it head on.
Alright. Okay. Just gotta go to, hold on a minute. Make sure I'm tracking it first. Here we go. Travel to Hoth.
Hello, Captain. Thanks for making your way all the way out there. Your work on Balmora was superb. The Military Expenditure Committee has even stopped harassing me about my crazy privateer idea. And let me apologize up front. Hoth is hardly one of the galaxy's top vacation spots.
Alright. Hoth's not so bad.
Just drop the whole thing in a big Corellian whiskey and it's fine.
I'll toast to that. Here are the facts. Until a few years ago, Hoth was a frozen wasteland with zero habitation except the occasional pirate ship. Which would still be the case if we hadn't lost our most advanced secret fleet in the ambush above it. With the number of ships that went down, we and the Imperials are both stuck here, battling it out to claim this rotten ice lick.
Alright, well, why send me?
Battlefield tactics aren't really my specialty.
That's not why you're here. Right now, neither the Republic nor the Empire claims Hoth's airspace. We were driven out by some witless pirates called the White Maw. Somehow these outlaws have acquired such a supremely advanced cloaking technology that they can outmaneuver both the Republic and the Empire.
Okay, and the Republic wants whatever they have?
So you want me to steal the cloaker from them?
Beg, buy, borrow, steal. We're not picky. This cloaking device, whatever it is, makes their ships basically invisible to instruments. We can't see them coming. We can't stop them, and neither can the Empire. We need this device, and we need you to get it for us.
Alright, what's in it for me?
You're not gonna sweeten the pot?
All we want is the tech. Anything else you find, make your own plans how to dispose of it. When you get planet side, speak to Major Painan. He'll be your point of contact and tell you anything else you need to know.
Okay. Well, that's gonna wrap it up for today. And tomorrow... I think tomorrow I'm probably going to play this again, and then on Saturday and Sunday I'll try and do more of a Doki Doki Literature Club, maybe, and then we'll continue like we normally do on the week as well, and then I'll have my normal days off being Saturday, and I'm probably just going to take Saturday and Sunday off. Although, I might, I probably can stream next week on Monday. Wait, no, next week on Monday I'm probably going to be busy, a little bit more busy, because I got an appointment to go to on the, I think it's the 26th. But, yeah. But I hope, everyone has a good weekend and a better week than I have. I will see you later. Goodbye.